back. So let's bring out the incredible director, the guy himself, the man of the hour, Mr. Deon Taylor. All right, guys, so you saw it with an urban world crowd. So what did you think of this experience, staying here with a crowd?
People were screaming, laughing. I'm sure some people were scared out of their minds.
What did you guys think of being here and seeing it with this
crowd? People screaming.
Yeah.
I said before we first came to here, there's nothing in the world like us. You know that? I like the DJs.
Oh, 1 second, all right. Also, wait, Mr. Mouse himself, Tyrese.
Hello.
I was just asking everybody how they felt watching the film with an audience as important as the urban world audience.
Yeah, I was just saying it was incredible. I had a blast and like screened the movie a few times and had great reactions. I mean, New York, man, this is like, I was trying to find an apartment online. Like, I don't think I'm moving on out of here. Thank you so much.
Shit, I don't even know who you are.
upset. She had the cornrows cracking. You know what I mean? It was so cracking. I was like, damn, you clean up well. But I'm just grateful. And you guys, y'all energy while watching this movie, y'all just made us really believe that we really are on the side. Movies out here. Y'all are so focused and engaged and clapping and cheering and rooting and screaming. I'm like, man, we really did some shit.
Some of the young signs, we forgot we was up there jumping too, because I'm like, that forgot me.
First of all, thank you for sharing a story that puts black women at the front to fight. Being morally right and going for what's right, no matter what anyone says about you. And I think that's so powerful. And Naomie Harris, goodness gracious. Like, what a performance from her. But why this story and why now? This is about an African-American cop. Why now? Why this story now?
You know what, it's an interesting lot. It was a perfect storm for the movie. When they handed me the screenplay to this, I had never been on a studio film. And I was happy Eric Kent handed me the script. And it was like, do whatever you want to do to it. And when I read it, immediately, it sparked interest because I had never ever, and then I looked this up later, I had never seen a film with a black female lead as a police officer in cinematic history. And when I researched and found out this would be the first movie, it blew my mind. And then secondly, you know, I was raised by a single mother in Gary, Indiana, and in the projects with nothing but her. And my mom became my dad, my mom became my basketball coach, my mom fought for me and my brothers. I've seen my mom get into fights at basketball tournaments. So it was easy for me because I've always watched strong black women my entire life. And that's always been foreign to me over the last 35 years. I hear people go, yeah, what about a black woman? And then people guess about it, like, there's no guessing with me. So this was an easy call. Being able to get someone like Naomie was pretty incredible. I had seen her work. I had no idea she was English, and I had seen her work in Moonlight. And after I seen her in Moonlight, I went and did the research and found out she was in 5 movies that I absolutely love, and I never identified her. So I was like, wait, this is the same girl in Pirates of the Caribbean and James Bond, and I said, who is that? And I fell in love with her. And I FaceTimed her and asked her to do this film. And she had never been a lead in the film, but she was just like, I would love to work with you, you know? And she had seen The Intruder, which was really cool because she loved what Dennis Quaid did in that film. And she was like, whatever, how have you got him to do that? And I would like to be a part of something like that. And when I watched the movie tonight with everyone here, what a beautiful portrait that she painted for all of us. I mean, I'm watching her and I'm looking at all these beautiful women out here and I'm like, that's the superhero movie right there. You know what I mean? And I'm just blessed, like I said before, to even be here, man. So those are the reasons that went into me taking a job and shooting a movie with a studio. If they had not given me the liberties, I would have been working in the studio ever.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so that was kind of cool.
Yes. And I feel like one of the most moving and powerful scenes was when you were getting arrested as Mouse, and there was the tear falling from your eye. You both about what you guys, how you prepared for that scene, and what you wanted audiences to really see.
I was excited because that was a really powerful moment on set for us. I was challenging, and I still am challenging for this film once it gets out, why I want people to watch it. I want to hear what a lot of the critics think about that moment. And why I want to ask that and challenge critics, because that really means something to us. The fact of the matter is that when you're African-American, when you're black in this country right now, since 3-4 years old, when the police pull up behind my mom, everybody has to sit up and not turn around. We're scared. When you get pulled over as a teenager, we're scared. And if you have had trouble or felonies or have any issues with the law or in your past, at any second, you can go back to jail and be killed, right? And that moment for this character, Miles, was so powerful based on the fact that he was an ex-felon. He does have a record. So at a moment's notice, if that police officer just feels like handcuffing him, which he did, and putting him in the car, this dude could be going back to jail for 2-3 years. It don't matter who birthday it is, don't matter who's sick. And Tyrese was brilliant enough in this moment to make me understand that tear was for everyone who has had to deal with that moment in their lives. And I was blown away. And that was real from him. And a very tough day on set, but a beautiful moment. No doubt. So.
Central, and I used all that for that moment. Thank you.
make sure that you were able to show us this woman who's obviously been through a lot, but is still here, still standing.
Well, I'm from Philly.
All day.
I mean, it was really about, you know, pulling from my own life experiences, pulling from my friends. I had friends who had friends with the police and who are now, you know, either incarcerated or dead. So it's really just about pulling from reality. Growing up in Philly was all the motivation and the inspiration that I needed for this character. We all know someone who's like this character. I could have been that character if I didn't make the choices that I made. So I think it's important for the audience to, you know, like you said, be able to see that character, see your sister, see your cousin, who are living those experiences as we speak. And I know at first, you know, it seems like she's a hothead and she's rebellious, but, you know, you empathize with her because you see in the end she has a heart. And not everybody in the hood or in the projects are bad or evil. You know, they're just part of their circumstances. So I believe we still have to tell those stories for our people so they can see themselves and also see the change within themselves at the end of the movie.
To all of the press and media that's here, by a show of hands, I just want to know blogs, websites, press, media that's still here. I don't say this that often, and I've been in the game for a nice little while now. We need y'all on this one.
Yeah.
Lunches and dinners, and you know, make me feel good, and make me feel warm and fuzzy, and maybe I'll write something great about your movie. We need y'all. We need y'all. October 25th, it's about to get real. I can tell y'all right now, I got 30 million on Facebook. I got almost 12 million on Instagram. And if they hate it, I'm just writing a tag. You know what I mean? So we all trying to get our numbers up out there. You understand? But we need you. We need you. We really.
Tyrese, inside the body cam office with the other cop, we literally shot the entire scene in 6 minutes. We did 24 setups in 6 minutes with a running camera at 2 o'clock in the morning to shoot that. And we almost passed out, but I understood very quickly that there was no tomorrow. And a lot of people don't understand filmmaking and don't understand independent filmmaking. That's the word I come from. I've done 20-hour days. I've been with grips and electric and camera people where they like, I can't go again. And because you don't have any money to come back. You know, The Intruder, we shot for $3 million in 20 days. People don't understand how hard and treacherous that is. You don't have any time. And when you're able to get a performance like this, performance like that, and deliver a film like that on the studio level in that many days, we do need you guys to write something nice and support what we're trying to do as black filmmakers. You know what I mean? We really do. And we need the audience and the people that's out here supporting us to really go out and support the movie. Mm. We don't have $500 in P&A. We have you guys to tell other people to go check out the movie and support Deon and Tyrese.
Before I walked in the theater, they told me that today's audience, along with the press and PR, will actually be the first press and PR on any level that our movie is going to get.
Oh, wow. I didn't know that. That's great. Up here. This is not microwave. You gotta actually get in the oven.